Welcome to the first video in Course 2. The content for this video comes from Module 1, Content Strategy. This video will detail how to conduct an environmental scan. The video will cover why you should perform an environmental scan, key considerations to keep in mind when doing an environmental scan, and how to go about conducting an environmental scan. Before creating your publishing program and deciding what approach you want to take, you need to be informed by a needs assessment or environmental scanning process. Through this, you can see what initiatives are already in place at your institution, what kinds of programs other institutions are running, what kinds of services stakeholders at your institution might be interested in, and assess other relevant information that may affect your potential publishing program. Ultimately, you are seeking to establish where you can best fill a need. This way, you can minimize risk and establish future directions. An if we build it, they will come approach is risky and could result in a significant amount of work to launch a program that withers from lack of interest and uptake. So make sure you do this work before starting your program. The following considerations can help guide your environmental scan and refine your strategy. Are there populations on your campus that are historically underrepresented in the existing scholarly literature? If so, are there opportunities to connect with scholars beyond your institution to create publications in response to this omission? Are faculty, students, or departments on your campus self-publishing journals that could benefit from a more centralized publisher and economies of scale? Other considerations include: does your campus host on-campus conferences or symposia that produce or informally publish proceedings? And has the university started a new major or degree program that will require new course materials? If so, could your press participate in creating free or affordable options? Other considerations include: are there opportunities to approach university administration, departments, or faculty about creating publications in response to stated needs? And are there other formal publishers on your campus, such as a university press? How might you partner with them? So the next thing we're going to talk about is how to go about conducting an environmental scan. So libraries can begin by undertaking a campus publishing audit or inventory to locate potential partners who already publish or would like to publish scholarly work. You can also scan departmental or faculty websites or CVs in search of depositable content. This may turn up an array of self-published journals, white papers, as well as other content. Librarians can also consider conducting a more formal web survey or what is also called a listening tour with faculty. Through this, you can ask faculty about publishing activities and pain points. Make sure you also include the broader university in your environmental scan. Look for opportunities related to the university's strategic plan, such as an expanded focus on specific areas of research, and for opportunities based on the library's goals, perhaps related to student success. In this video, we have discussed why you should conduct an environmental scan, some key considerations that can help guide your scan and refine your strategy, as well as tips on how to go about completing an environmental scan.